light.
Hi. Demos really hyped up for the match. And here we go, final destination, Luigi versus Zidaset. And they start with just Snorlax with Luigi and his fireballs and Zidaset and her neutralizers and aerials on shield. Very safe on both sides. No one is really taking a risk except Jay Miller with his dash attack that's punished by a down throw from Demos. And here we come, another down throw from Jay Miller to double fair. And okay, they come back, they go back to the simply poking phase. There, no one taking a risk. Jay Miller shielding a lot for Luigi. Dash up smash, he was trying to take. Oh! Jay Miller was. In my opinion, he was trying to avoid the down B spike of ZSS. That's why he waited so long before coming back with a B. And here we have a 50% advantage on for Luigi.
Who have we seen already in this matchup? We've commentated already Jay Miller versus Zero Suit.
I haven't seen. I don't think we had Jay Miller versus Zero Suit on stream. And Jay Miller is having a great advantage, just playing coolly, spamming smashes.
And the real definition of playing coolly. Oh, very close situation where both players stayed in shield back to back.
Yeah, no one trying to take the advantage.
Oh, nice B reading the roll in.
And Jay Miller managed to DI out, and he could avoid certain days this way. So now it's really even, because if Demos manages to land a grab, a down throw, a pair, a B, and Jay Miller was too far
the
away.
The back air will take it. Oh, creating such pressure with his aerial movement and keeping his double jump so as to be able to punish Luigi's drifting. He managed to land the back air and take off Luigi's first stock, where when he only had 100%, and Jay Miller reads this roll but doesn't manage to get the up smash he wanted.
Yeah. And now he wants to close this stock before it's before Demos takes off gives too many percent. So neutral air, not followed up, up air, still coming up the percent. Demos at 150. Very risky dash attack on the edge.
I'm not sure about this option, it was probably a missed input. Still, didn't get punished too badly.
Yeah.
Up smash won't get punished.
Oh, and the back out of shield punished the whiff jab from Demos.
Such a strong
option. Only 40% on Jay Miller. And the down smash to down B, the famous. You love it, everyone loves it. And it's a full stock advantage for Demos now. It was 40% 30 seconds ago. Jay Miller with the down B to cover his landing.
Again, the down B used to trick Demos and punish his landing, as you said.
Fair to net, to full jab. Demos doesn't shoot the last hit of the jab.
Jay Miller being a fan of this jab, I've noticed. Double up air. I wonder if this is an effect of the patch. Since it has the same knockback as before, it will put the opponent in the same position as before. So the distance relative to the B is the same. But since it deals less damage, it has less stun. So you might not be able to connect with a B as easily as before.
Yeah, that's true. Since its stun is completely reliant on the percentage of the characters. So Jay Miller could escape it. And now he's at its last stock at 70%.
Very dangerous percent.
Yeah, there's a jab down smash from ZSS. Oh, it touches, not followed up. Because
he wasn't sure he could get the follow-up he needed, and anyway, with a full up tomahawk, he managed to get a landing grab. Demos being very safe in this match, I've noticed. This roll could have gotten punished very badly, but
and
this time...
What did the upkeep class
so, with a jab from Luigi, and it interacted in a very weird way. ZSS up tilt has a... How do you put it?
It has the cannot rebound state.
Exactly, it cannot rebound much like much of Little Mac's moveset.
Yeah.
And this time it actually backfired on Demos in the hitbox and up tilt was cancelled, but he was still in the animation and got punished for it by an up smash after having cancelled Jamie's jab.
Now Joe Miller is at 130. Really managed to pull it back. How can he pull it back?
He needs this. He needs some very solid Luigi Grandpa with lots of perfect shield. This is what Luigi needs to be able to get in and get some openings, something like that. The problem is, since all of Zidane's aerials are safe and shield, you also need to be very close to her to punish her, even if you get a perfect shield. And he hasn't been able to find these openings yet.
Yeah, exactly. Now, he's just counting his fireballs, ready to find an opening.
Any percent,
yeah. Demos trying to land this back air.
Oh, we can see Jaminer clearly fishing for something, trying to get Deimos to roll into him at some very dangerous time. Here we got the beginning, the startup of an up smash, which got bet by ZSS Neutral Air.
ZSS Neutral Air, which is already very safe on shield,
and
safer on Luigi's shield.
Very, very dangerous persons right now. Deimos 80% on ZSS, and this charge up smash will punish Deimos' landing!
That kills Deimos at like 87%. It is the comeback. 100.
Incredible positioning. For the all the duration of the game, Jaminer really respected Deimos' aerial movements. He stayed on the same spot, and only when Deimos moved around with roll, he himself rolled, and some card began punish for it. Sometimes tried to punish Deimos' roll, but right now he let Deimos take to the airs and then dash right away, charging an up smash, expecting him to go for his usual pattern, which is a safely retreat in the air, and Deimos didn't react in time, just fell right into Jamila's charge up smash, which gave him this insane comeback with only like what, 80% on zero suit before
it
the
kill? It was a fully charged up smash with 150 rage, it killed at 80%. So Jamila with the lean right now. Deimos counter picking on Smashville with no surprises. And trying to land his jab to down smash, that's a really risky mix-up. The Miller just mashed the jab out of it.
Gets hit by down smash to three up air and misspaces the up just a tiny bit.
And Jay Miller escapes certain deaths like that. Now it's really even at the percentage. Oh, first hit of fail that pushes Luigi off stages.
Deimos rolling away safely from Luigi's amazing boxing game.
Yep. Trying to side B his way in. Only to get his aerial shield grab.
No double jump on ZSS. How
no
will
problem. Okay. He only had two other recovery options left. Poor ZSS. So, really, Deimos spamming back airs then again. The neutral air that gets connected to a forward air. Don't be really not at the right place to spike.
Again.
Deimos really taking his time in the air.
Again, we've seen Deimos go. Oh, he get punished badly. Oh. No! Jay Miller waits way too long and doesn't get the charge of F smash money, but still manages to get the down smash not too long after. Very, very. This is when you can say the nerves are coming into play. Like, I really want this kill. He didn't even go for the up smash, which is the go to smash with Luigi. He wanted a special kind of punish, something you know is even more powerful that you cannot DI properly when you're at this point on the stage, and he nearly didn't get the kill.
Yeah, just because I think Deimos fast forward is a B, landing earlier and having the time to spot dodge. But then, falling into Jay Miller's down smash right after that to get
so many rolls.
Yeah.
But good rolls from Jay Miller, which allowed him to evade Zero Suit's grab. Okay, what punish will you go for?
With him.
That was actually a frame trap from Optimal! Optimal
79%! And it's the second kill. Jaminer at its first stock still, while Deimos is at its last.
Didn't mess around this time, didn't go for like a charge for a smash or whatever, just run up a B.
And show you can. Deimos taking Jaminer's first stock just after that. But still having needing to get another.
And
the
spike! Will he make it back? He still has
he
used
the
double jump. Yep. But still very, very good
opening. That's the comeback Deimos needed. Oh, neutral air to spot dodge.
And that's why Zero Suit is such a scary character. Her neutral game, while solid, still has flaws when you compare it to the one of other top tier characters. And even Luigi's, when you play him as defensively and safely as a J-meter. But when you get these openings, these crazy openings from neutral airs or down smash, you get these follow-ups and sometimes very early kills, just like right now.
Yeah. The down B killing at 40% is always a terrible threat. It was started too low.
Well, pops on the top, right. Like it did send him close to the top blast zone, but didn't kill.
Because the last hit didn't connect. Not enough rage.
And again, a down smash. Bye. And Deimos,
giving the crowd the thumbs up to show he's still here, even though he was. It was a reverse three stock.
Yeah, absolutely. This was a very, very hype comeback.
It was
from
on the verge of losing and then pulled it back with crazy kills at a low percent two times.
And this is mindset at its finest. Like, he didn't crumble from the pressure. He got a bead. He could have been killed really easily off of a missed up B. But he didn't let it shake him. He got these very crazy punishes and managed to take the game in the end. And so I think this is the third match and the second on Final Destination, right?
Exactly. So there aren't DSRs.
Absolutely.
Because it's two bans and Deimos didn't ban FD. I guess he banned Lylat and Duck Hunt.
Yeah, probably. This is this tournament uses a full list striking rule set,
which is no DSR.
Yeah, which is kind of experimental from in France.
Yeah.
So no bans. The cross up jab won't get punished by Luigi's back air.
Yeah, already 60% on the test. But as we saw earlier, percentage doesn't mean anything as long as he can get his down B. Deimos can afford to take as many percentage as he wants.
Okay, smash. Okay,
smash has anti-air very well done by Jamila, but too early to kill sadly.
Anyway, a good anti-air option because he was getting way too much pressure from Deimos' empty short hops and short hops neutral air. And the pressure from the down air to neutral air. You have to respect the number of aerials that Luigi can pull out in one short hop.
The dash attack we finished that went on shield. Deimos! Oh yeah, that's the down B we love. You're too high. Oh, I can't spike you. It would be a shame if I could just have hit so you. Little lag that I can jump and back air to you.
And hit you is my strongest aerial.
Yeah. Very well done by Deimos.
Misses a back air, which could have led to something huge since J-Miller had already used his double jump.
Yeah.
And this time, J-Miller is really struggling to find openings.
Deimos.
Going for some quick movement on the ground, dash instant and stuff, but still.
The sure spot back air hitting. Deimos offstage, and what the fuck is he doing?
No take from Deimos. This down smash always sends you behind Luigi, so if you go for a downward DI, you can try to take it on the edge, but Deimos wasn't ready for that, and didn't save his life. He might not have been able to, I'm not sure.
I didn't understand why Deimos went and wasted his ledge invincibility.
I think that was just a misinput.
Yeah, that's probably that. Still, 60% advantage on Deimos. J-Miller will have to slowly get it back while keeping safe from ZSS setups.
Okay, neutral air. Down smash will be safe and shield, but okay.
Oh, the run up grab.
Jab will grab. Will launch. Oh! The down B with spikes! Absolutely. I was like, there's no way in this matchup you can actually go for these down B games that we've seen J-Miller go for already numerous times. But if ZSS decides to go for a very low side B or a B, shield is herself wide open to something like that. And J-Miller saw his opening and caught it immediately.
Exactly. There we have 137% on meter. And just the back air on the frame. On the frame of the getup.
And this is the third match of top 8, so I assume we'll see at the end of the match. Very nice back air to dash grab.
Down throw, fair. Deimos did that really well. And went behind Jamie Earth, denying him follow up on this grab.
Again, we see this this filthy game with lots of rolls coming into play. The neutral edge down B
almost kills.
So this is actually warranted for a wider range of percents since neutral edge got a percent nerf. But in this case, Deimos didn't get the spike he wanted. Back throw.
The SSM stage.
Uh oh! But Jamiller tries to shield grab this instead of. absolutely, blue bar punish instead of the optimal punish he went for earlier in the set. Lots of pressure. The crowd is going absolutely bonkers on the other side of the room. We're kind of thinking in.
Is it because of that or is it because of the doubles? We won't know. The back air.
And again, this shot will get punished.
Getting punishes,
putting so much pressure on Jamiller at the edge that he actually committed to this wall, which is the option Deimos was waiting for with his backer spacing. So actually, two up for Deimos versus Jamiller's one,
those
and the players both, like, both got
checking up. And saying GG's, they're not realizing it's better five because it's in top eight.
And so we have an upset in the losers bracket.
Omika. Wait,
no, in the, where is it? Yeah, in the loser's bracket, Omika, so formerly known as Sangoten, if some of our international viewers remember him. He was just beneath the top level in France back in Brawl. He was a Pikachu player. Right now he's moved, he's changed tags.
Now they're going back to
FG. Jeff again. Well, FG. So here we go.
Okay,
neutral air. Wow, this is so... Wait, there's a controller. Oh, okay, since they had to unplug the controller and plug it back again, will we have a gentleman reset or just an agreement to continue the game? Yep, gentleman reset. Okay. So this allows us to catch a breather, check the chat's reaction.
Fini!
So yeah, Gluttony is actually out. This is very probably one of the clear favorites. Of this tournament, most people in their in predictions put him as either first, second, or third, which is Bayonetta. And right now, we've got Omika, who took back-to-back Dev Skill, another Bayonetta-only player, and, well, Gluttony, probably one of the most fearsome we have, with a 3-2 victory. Anyway, here we go back in this set, Jamiller versus Deimos. Again,
2-1 for Deimos.
Again, the FT peak.
Yeah. Really getting crazy in there. Two of the three Bayonettas we had in top 8 are out. Now, we're having Deimos that's fighting with Polly has to take Miller out of the winner's bracket. And right now, he's doing a pretty good job, like leading 2-1.
A lot of what we are seeing in the ground game from both these players is Jamiller trying to rush in. Oh, this buff side B could have been it. Trying to rush in and find the nifty dash grabs he needs. Oh! And the down smash on the true frames from Jamiller's up B.
The edge grab frames.
Huge lead for Deimos.
Tried it multiple times on the previous match and it just managed to get it this one time, and that's a kill at. I think Miller was at 100% after the downbeat.
Yeah, just a little bit of that, so, I think.
And as always, ZSS with the very early kills.
And like, why not go for that? Except for the stage controls, there's no way you're getting punished from the down smash if you time it right, since he has so little lag. So it's really just like very high reward, very low risk.
Yeah.
Okay, nice back here to shield. And oh!
The down smash? Charged on smash that kills at 104%.
I'm not sure how much of a read that was from Miller, if he expected another back roll from Deimos. Anyway, he crouched using the animation from the down smash and this way avoided the backers that Deimos has been using to punish his roll and kill him for that. So, very, very quick comeback from Jamiller since he lost his stock at such. With such low percent on Deimos.
That's very, very even matchup right now. Deimos finding up. Jamiller just fairing the air. Deimos
double rolls.
usual back air spam, just to condition. It cost him the stock last game when Jamila caught up and yeah, just finished him with up smash. It was a bit too early this time, but right now both players are really ready.
I'm not sure. I think this was a missed input. We saw him dashing towards the left side.
Yeah.
I think he tried to dash right and do
jump cancel the reverse smash, up smash. Yeah. And he just dash dance up smash instead, and that might have cost him the stock, because right now Demos is leading, not anymore. 0%, one stock match. If Demos wins that, he will go in winners finals. And Miller has to be really, really careful, especially with those backer chains, upper chains.
That's funny, because Miller aged like 1,000 uppers, but still kept his double jump thinking about the time he needed to land, and this allowed him actually to only get hit by the full sequence of the uppers, and not something nastier after that.
Yeah. Well done. Still 50% behind. The most spamming the down smashes on the edge.
Okay, nice back air this time, answering with Deimos shot ups. This time Jamila takes to the air
down
instead
air.
Of absolutely, instead of just staying on the ground and
down
finding up smashes.
Forward air, double fireball, just to zone it.
Wow,
very risky.
This was definitely a read. He definitely saw the jab coming and tried to just out-prioritize the option Deimos would go for after his safe back air.
Jamila just using his shield against Deimos' down smashes. Both players are playing really, really careful. Deimos not falling into
and this time again, this dash up smash will catch Deimos standing. Well, lots of pressure on Deimos. He's actually thinking very hard about his next pick. And Jamila again showing that even though he lost his stock extremely early with the two-frame down smash, he's still very much into this.
Sorry,
No, you have two bans.
No,
there's
two bans, but no
David Stuber. No, c'est bon, deux bans et DSR. On n'est pas chez Pirastek ici.
So obviously, since we're in a FLSS, there's no DSR. Just made that sure with Jamler. So he needs to ban two stages now. And since he's against Zero Suit, I suppose he will ban the stage with the most platforms like Dreamland and Battlefield.
Or not on NCT, because Jamila can benefit from it.
Yeah, absolutely. He had most of his kills with the up smashes. Yeah, and even though it sends at a very diagonal angle, when you catch the opponent off guard, like in the middle of a short hop, for instance, it will mostly send them up. And so, what the hell is this pick? I'm really unsure about this pick, even though it allows Deimos to go for a very clean and precise spacing. Like, there's no platforms to annoy him with his back air pressure on Jamila's shield. It's also Jamila's pick in all the games he's won. So I'm not sure if this is such a smart choice. And again, neutral air to down smash, to neutral air to first hit front air. If he had connected with both hit of the front air, we could have seen a much longer and nastier combo than what he's seen.
The neutral air perfect shielded. The leader really, really done game right now. After all, fireball.
Okay, this will get him punished. No,
fair that misses just by. The most that energies.
And this dash up smash! Nearly.
Almost died from this dash attack. Really, Deimos needs to reevaluate his risk-reward dodge right now. Oh, Miller saw the roll, but no rage on his VG, so he won't kill.
Up smash again, will catch Deimos in the middle of his short hop. He needs to watch out for these, because Jamil has been absolutely on the hunt for these opportunities. Okay, neutral air to front air, won't find an up air, punish the landing with Nair with the back air.
It must be a bit too close from the edge.
We'll get punished with nearly 30% from this very simple combo.
Yeah.
Dash attack.
Demos outsped by Luigi neutral air.
Demos not crumbling, not going for the obvious rolls yet. He still has some fight left in him. tries to actually pressure Jay Miller on the edge.
Spacing is neutralized, but one whiff and Jay Miller takes just 20 of Bison's inclination. Drop smash, Jay Miller wants it again. He knows it's his best key move.
Okay, neutraler will trade his up air and will allow Jay Miller to land kind of
and
safely.
And short of back air, that deals the suck.
Well, this is very, very tough for Deimos. 120%, he cannot get hit by an anti-air or anti-roll up smash.
Yeah, he has to watch his short ups really, really closely. The double fireball to up smash from Jay Miller, and that was seen by Deimos. Oh, and the down smash that low profiles and dodges the neutral air from Deimos. Kills him at 120.
This is tough, this is very tough for Deimos.
Yeah. It's his last tuck.
Absolutely, possibly his last tuck in the winner's bracket. He would need to go through a tough loser's bracket to get back close to the grand finals.
Yeah.
Okay.
Not even grand finals, it's just winner semis.
Yep. Jay Miller putting a lot of pressure. Yeah. All the times that he's been going for fireballs, he's got an amazing openings, forcing Deimos to come closer to him in the middle of his short up spacing because he doesn't want to land into a fireball. And thus,
throw from Luigi. He keeps it simple, he keeps the guaranteed damage, he doesn't want to force a mix up. Okay, Deimos with his back air. He couldn't link. Smash to his up B.
Deimos needs something huge, like another down smash. He just had his opportunity but wasted it. We'll get punished by his panic up tilt.
That punishes the up tilt. Really, really well done by Miller. Very patient. He didn't go for the direct punish.